Hello, I'm Jelle.
I'm Chris.
I'm Tom.
Martijn.
Jeroen.
We are 1426 and you are watching Live Prague.
The life of a reviewer can sometimes be very interesting because, well, very often unexpected music falls into your lap. Such as the album I have in this review, by the band Flavor. And the album is called Seeing is Deceiving. I thought that was an interesting title. The band sent me an email prior to sending me the CD, and they had a very small description of the band. The band hails from Tallinn, Estonia, and they were formed in 2008. It's an instrumental band that tries to combine different styles like funk, fusion, jazz, progressive rock, all together by using somewhat different instruments than you normally expect. They have a Chapman stick player, they use electric wind instruments. I have an idea what it is, but you know, surprise me. And what I noticed is they don't have a guitar player. What's very important to their music is that they do it very spontaneously. A lot of it is based on improvisation. It's a bit of a different band. Now, I'm all up for that. I like that, especially when they make good music that I like to listen to. That's always the standard for me. If I put on an album, I have to enjoy myself. And if I don't enjoy myself, I don't like the album. That's very simple. Now, I tried to look up some information about this band, some more information, but, well, there's no website. I googled them, but I couldn't find a website. So, that's basically all the information I have. The booklet doesn't say much either, just this, with some lyrics and the CD. And on the rear we have, a little bit of information about the band. I said they were instrumental, and yet they have lyrics. Three tracks out of the six have vocals on them, so they're not entirely instrumental, although in the last track it's not really singing, because there are no lyrics listed for the last song. It's a lot of wordless vocals. To start with the singer, listed as a guest performer, Tuuli Velling is the singer. From what I hear, it's a female singer, and I gotta say she has a very beautiful voice. Accents or anything. I really enjoyed listening to her vocals. There's one other guest performer, Hendrik Maripu, who plays some guitars on the first track. And those are the only guitars on the album, because the rest of the band, Indrek Varend plays saxophone, Maris Mühl keyboards, Raymond Maggi bass and Chapman sticks, and Piep Kallas on drums. So, no guitar player, saxophone. That's a very important instrument that you hear on this album. Listening to it, I gotta say, some songs had a bit of a mixed emotion. There are a couple of songs that I really enjoyed, found really beautiful. Six tracks, three of them singing, three of them instrumental. The opening track, Broken, is the first one with vocals. And when I was listening to it, you clearly hear the whole idea of improvising. It doesn't follow any lines, any structures. It's had some psychedelic elements in it, and that is a song that really, might take a while, to get used to adjust to. I like the name Flavor. I often compare music to food, because food also has different kind of flavors, and you can combine flavors, and you can make them, into something really nice, into a new flavor, but also food is something you can learn to appreciate, and the same is with music. Music is something you can learn to appreciate. If you open your mind, if you listen to it, you can learn to like music. Now, I gotta say, this one may take you some time to get the flavor your own, you know? The second track is a song I very much love. It's called Antarctica. It's very ambient, very beautiful, with again, the very beautiful saxophone in it. But also, the whole song made me feel like there's a link between this and electronic music. Because it sounds very electronic and very laid back and very atmospheric. It's definitely a highlight of the album. The other tracks are also very good. The fourth track, Oscar, was the only track that, you know, I listened to it again, and it takes a long time before it finally takes off, and then, you know, you get in the moment and then you enjoy the music, and then it takes a long time to slow down again. It's a fairly long track, about 7 minutes. I think if they made it a little shorter, it would have been a little better. It's still a nice track, but it's too long. And it, the beginning and the end doesn't really seem to go somewhere. The middle part is very good. The title track, Seeing is Deceiving, is also a very good one. The saxophone is a constant factor throughout the whole album, especially in the instrumental songs. Now, I'm normally not a jazz kind of guy. If music is jazz or fusion, I usually tend to say no. I don't like it, I don't listen to it myself. But sometimes, you know, I can make an exception. If they do it in such a way that I can really start to appreciate the flavor, and really enjoy listening to it, well, then I will. And that is the case with this album, because a lot of it is very jazz, very fusion based, sometimes even plain jazz, but with different instruments, so it still sounds a little bit different. But I gotta say, I really enjoyed listening to this album. You know, if you're interested in something different, something outside the box, something outside the main, you know, vastness of proc releases, well, then I would certainly recommend you give Flavor a try. You might even enjoy it. Flavor, Seeing is Deceiving.